Derbyshire's batsmen dominate on day one against Durham. Fourth place Derbyshire hosted Durham in their match this week, the home side desperate for a win having lost convincingly to Warwickshire in their last fixture. Durham sat ninth in the table and were looking for their second win of the season as the teams took to the field for round five. The toss was uncontested and Derbyshire batted first, openers Slater and Rees getting off to a fantastic start. Both batsmen played confidently, dominating the Durham attack. The score raced past 50 as both openers continued to play their strokes. The Durham bowlers couldn't find a way through and it wasn't long before Slater brought up his 50 off 72 balls. The batting pair cruised along, taking their opening stand past 100, things not looking good for Durham as lunch was taken, Derbyshire 107 without loss. Re-energised after the interval, the Durham attack looked much more threatening as the afternoon session got underway, and Rimmington got the much-needed breakthrough, Clark taking the catch to send Slater packing for 55. Rees looked to push on, but he soon joined his opening partner back in the pavilion, caught behind off Whale for 48. Durham suddenly had momentum, and whilst Madsen took on the bowlers, his new partner Hughes only lasted 8 balls before he was bowled by Whale for a duck. Madsen, unfazed, continued to play with intent and was supported well by new batsman Godelman, who played some fine shots to take Derbyshire past 150. Godelman grew in confidence, dispatching the Durham attack, and he cruised to his own 50, his partnership with Madsen reaching 100 as tee was taken, the score 226-3 at tee. Good session for the hosts, despite the loss of 3 wickets. Durham needed a breakthrough as Godelman and Madsen returned to the middle for the evening session. The Derbyshire pair picked up where they'd left off though, Madsen soon reaching his half century, this milestone coming off 93 balls. Just a couple of overs later, his partner Godelman was out, trapped LBW by Dixon for 61. Critchley was the new man in though, and he started his innings well, finding numerous boundaries. Both he and Madsen quickly taking their stand past 50, but their run was halted due to bad light, and stumps was called not long afterwards. So the score at the end of the day, 301-4, solid displays of batting from the home side, putting them in a comfortable position going into day two. Madsen the standout at this stage, he sits unbeaten on 80, Whale the pick of the bowlers with 2-48. The Durham attack looking for improvements and some early wickets when play resumes on day two. Derbyshire post big first innings total to put pressure on Durham on day two. Derbyshire dominated with the bat on day one at Derby, the hosts reaching 301-4 at stumps with Madsen and Critchley unbeaten on 80 and 35 respectively. The pair returned to the middle on day two looking to push on, but after only adding 17 runs to the overnight score, Wood wrapped the pads of Madsen and he was sent back to the pavilion for 85. That brought Schmidt to the crease, who supported Critchley to his half century. Critchley then moved on to 64 before he was sent packing by Collingwood, taking a catch off his own bowling. In came Vieljuan, who looked to stamp his authority on the match early on, but he soon became Collingwood's second victim as he fell for 9. Durham needed to capitalise, but new batsman Palladino batted well with Schmidt, and the pair played positively in their quest to secure 5 batting points. They fell 7 runs short of 400 in the end though, and settled for 4 batting points with the score 397-7 at lunch. A good morning for Durham, taking important wickets, but they still had work to do in the afternoon. Schmidt continued to bat confidently and was well supported by Palladino. They took their partnership to 62 when Steele eventually found a way through. Palladino removed for 29. 2 overs later, Steele struck again to send new batsman Olivier on his way for naught, Collingwood with the catch. That brought final batsman Rampall to the crease, who was pinned in front by Dixon the following over. Derbyshire all out for 427, Schmidt stranded on 45 not out. An excellent first inning score from Derbyshire with good contributions throughout. A tough time in the field for Durham, and after a change of innings, Steele and Markram needed to get their side off to a good start. Both batsmen looked in good touch as they ticked the score along, putting away the bad balls and taking the opening stand to 50. Vieljuan struck on the stroke of tee though, Markram caught behind for 30, the score 51-1 at the interval. A disappointing end to the session after a good start from the Durham openers, and there was more trouble for the visitors on the other side of the tea break. New batsman Smith falling victim to Viljoen, out for a duck. The pressure was on Durham, but Steele and Clark consolidated things, picking up the odd boundary as they took their partnership beyond 50. They progressed nicely and took the score to 115 for 2 before bad light brought play to an early close. A good start by Durham in their reply to Derbyshire's big first innings score, with Clark well set on 42 not out and Steele unbeaten on 31. The pair will return to the middle on day 3, with their side trailing by 312 runs and still with plenty of work to do. Pointer's ton levels proceedings at Derby. Derbyshire posted a big first innings total of 427 on day 2. Durham, in reply, made a good start to their first innings, reaching 115 for 2 at stumps. Clark was unbeaten on 42 and Steele 31 not out, and they returned to the middle on day 3 with their side trailing by 312 runs, looking to build on their 64-run partnership. Steele failed to add to his overnight score, though, before he was sent back to the pavilion by Olivier Godelman with the catch. A good start for Derbyshire, but Durham skipper Collingwood batted well as he got his innings underway and Clark soon brought up his half-century. The pair took the score past 150 and were looking good. However, Rampall managed to find the breakthrough, Collingwood caught behind for 27. The following over, he was joined back in the pavilion by Clark, trapped in front by Palladino for 63. Two important wickets for Derbyshire, but new batsmen, Richardson and Poynter, weren't fazed as they started to build a good partnership. They batted through to lunch, the score 217 for 5 at the break. 102 runs scored in the session for the loss of 3 wickets. Durham needed a big partnership as the afternoon session got underway, the hosts still trailing by 210. Richardson and Poynter made a steady start, playing themselves back in, and they gradually ticked the score along past 250. They proceeded to bring up their individual half-centuries and pushed on from there. Poynter accelerated, scoring regular boundaries, and Derbyshire grew frustrated, unable to find the breakthrough as Durham cruised past 300. Neither batsman looked likely getting out, and Poynter soon brought up a classy century, coming off 128 balls. As they returned to the middle for the evening session, the visitors trailed by just 62 runs, and Poynter and Richardson continued to dominate the Derbyshire attack, taking their partnership well beyond 200. Both batsmen were oozing in confidence, and the hosts tired as Durham's score surpassed 400. It wasn't long before Durham took the lead, and Richardson eventually reached his ton. Durham were flying, and it took a good delivery from Olivier to finally bring the 278-run partnership to an end. Poynter gone for an outstanding 170. 3 overs later, Palladino wrapped the pads of Richardson, and he was out for a fine 115. Whale and Wood were the new batsmen at the crease, and they batted well to take the score beyond 500. Palladino eventually got the breakthrough, removing Wood for 13, and the following over, Rimmington was trapped in front by Madsen for 3. With one wicket left, Dixon managed to pick up a couple of boundaries until Whale was caught behind off Palladino, Durham all out for 520. A fantastic effort from the visitors after Derbyshire's intimidating first innings total. Poynter and Richardson the obvious standout performers with their sublime hundreds. A tough time in the field for Derbyshire, and Slater and Rees had to see out a nervy 2 overs before stumps. The score, 1 without loss. A bad day for the hosts. Slater and Rees will return to the middle on the final day with their side trailing by 92. A draw the most likely result at this stage, but Durham will continue to fight hard after a brilliant day 3 performance. Derbyshire hold on despite inspired bowling from Wood. Centuries from both Richardson and Poynter helped Durham reach a total of 520 in their first innings on day 3 at the county ground. Derbyshire only had time to put one run on the board before close of play with Rees and Slater at the crease. They headed into the final day trailing Durham by 92. The pair didn't waste any time early on, grabbing a series of boundaries. Rees, however, didn't last much longer, dragging onto his own stumps off Mark Wood for 12, the Durham seamer doing his England hopes no harm. Madsen joined Slater at the crease and picked up where Rees left off, adding his fair share of boundaries. But Wood's magical morning continued. He had Madsen caught behind by Poynter for his second wicket of the session. Derbyshire were finally able to take the lead, with Hughes getting in on the act with some boundaries of his own. But the good feeling didn't last long as Wood once again took a wicket. He removed opener Slater for 42. With lunch on the horizon, Derbyshire could ill afford any more losses, but Hughes was next to depart, caught behind off a steel delivery. A positive morning from Durham as the teams headed off. Derbyshire with plenty to think about at lunch, 6 wickets still in hand, but they were only 21 runs ahead as things stood. A magical bowling display from Mark Wood, raising Durham's faint hopes of getting a positive result on day 4. It was a change of pace in the afternoon as Godelman and Critchley started building the Derbyshire lead. Without Wood in the attack, Durham struggled to find a breakthrough. Steele was the man to come to the fore for Durham, the spinner breaking up the Godelman-Critchley partnership when he dismissed the latter for 40. An over later and Godelman was on his way too, edging to Collingwood at first slip from a whale delivery. The 2 quick wickets leaving Derbyshire 185 for 6. Biljon and Smith were tasked with steadying the ship for Derbyshire and they responded. A steel delivery sent out of the stands by Biljon as they took the lead past 100. Wood returned to the Durham attack and immediately made an impact. Biljon attempting to drive a short ball caught in the slips by Markram. Derbyshire 213 for 7 and the Durham quick with 4 wickets in just 14 overs. No more wickets before tea, and with Derbyshire on 228 for 7 with a lead of 135, it was all for Durham to do to try and pick up a win. However, with Wood on this form, there was still a glimmer of hope for the visitors going into the evening session. Schmidt and Palladino made a steady start in the evening. That was until they came up against Wood. Coming around the wicket, he managed to find the outside edge of Schmidt's bat, Poynter with the catch. Wood now with figures of 5 for 46 from his 20 overs, and it didn't take him too long to pick up a 6th. Olivier edging behind to Poynter. Derbyshire's lead 149 with just the 1 wicket left. However, Rampall joined Palladino at the crease and the pair went on the offensive in an attempt to take the game beyond Durham whilst at the same time surviving as long as possible. In the end, their entertaining partnership was worth 37, including a 6 apiece off the bowling of Steele and Smith respectively. With a positive result for either side now beyond the realms of possibility, the captains decided to share the spoils.